Hey guys, today I'm going to show you another vintage piece by Sony. This is the Sony CDP-XA7es. The CD player came out in the 90s actually, and I'm fortunate enough to own one that is still working. It's a fantastic CD player. It weighs in about 30 pounds or so. I don't have the exact specs, but it's pretty heavy. Back in the 90s, this retailed for $3,000, so it's not cheap, and I'd like to show you guys what it looks like, and that it's still working, so I'm afraid that eventually it will die, and I won't be able to show you guys. So let's take a look at the unit itself. This is all aluminum. They sure don't make it like this anymore. This is the ES series. ES stands for elevated standards. So it's got a center tray. It's got a headphone output. The headphone app is actually really good too. If you were to pair it up with a pair of Sony headphones, it sounds fantastic. It's got your transport buttons, your play, stop, pause, and then it's got a digital output, so you can turn that on or off. And then, so what's so special about this unit? Let me show you. When you open this side up, the drawer itself, as you can see, it is very, very heavy and well made. This is sprayed with some sort of damping materials. It's all aluminum, so it is a very, very well made drawer. It's got rubber in here to seal the insides from outside noise and vibration and stuff. So this particular unit itself has a this is a weight for the CD. So when you put the CD in, I'll show you what it looks like. You see the lens right here? This is the fixed lens mechanism, I believe. So the CD itself moves back and forth. So you put the CD in like so, and then you place the counterweight on it. So what that does is it eliminates vibration from the spinning CD, and it creates a better sound. They sure don't make it like this anymore. As you can see, the CD balancer, it's all metal. It's got the Sony logo on it. This player will not play without this balancer, so don't lose it if you have one. So, and then close this guy. As you can see, it tracks very quickly. We'll hit play, and it's got the light. I mean, back in the day, they really put a lot of attention to details. It's got a light that turns on when it's playing. And then you change tracks. It's got a calendar to show you which track you're on and how many tracks left. As you can see, it tracks very quickly. So I will be... I'll show you what it looks like from the back. I'll just stop this guy, turn it off, and then I'm gonna set this camera on a tripod so I can turn this guy around. Like I said, this player is not light, so sorry, should have set this up earlier. Unplug it. When you're moving the CD player around, as you can see, this is all aluminum, very thick aluminum. The feet here are also very nice, well-made feet. Nothing here is plastic. So let me show you what it looks like from the back. I'm not sure if you can see this, this aluminum chassis has a piece of foam in between to dampen the vibration. So, I mean, this attention to details on this thing is superb, to say the least. So it's got your balance outputs, and it's got your fixed and variable output. What that means is that you can connect this straight to a preamplifier and use the volume control in the front to control the level. So really cool. It's got your balance on and off, coaxial and digital fiber optics output. As you can see, this was made in June 1998, made in Japan. So it's very well made. One thing I wish they had was a removable plug, but you know, I guess back then it wasn't a hit. So as you can see, all aluminum, very well made. It's about 30 pounds or so, maybe even 35. It's a fantastic player, still runs. I'm fortunate that it still plays, and just glad that I'm able to show you guys what this fantastic player looks like. You've been watching, this is the Sony CDP-XA7es. It was the top line player in the 90s, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. So please subscribe if you'd like to see more hi-fi gear, new and old. So if you're interested in vintage stuff, I do have some vintage stuff too. And subscribe, and you can follow me on Twitter. I'm at HiFiGuy528 on Twitter if you want to ask me questions and stuff. So, all right, thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.